I signed an authorization to be able to help her in the voting area, and she did very well.
Bernice Addix has difficulty walking and standing for extended periods of time. Thanks to changes made by the Maryland State Board of Elections more than a decade ago, her husband Franklin is able to help her cast her ballot.
They had a chair and that we could sit down, and we could bring the screen up so it would be larger print so we could make easier reading. So they made it very convenient for you.
All voting locations in the state of Maryland are required by law to be accessible. Ramps like these help handicapped voters get to the booths. But even with these laws in place, not all voters with disabilities feel their needs are being met. National Federation of the Blind President Mark Riccobono had to fight the state for those with visual disabilities to be included in the voting process.
If you're a blind person or really a person with other disabilities and you want to vote absentee, you don't have equal access to a secret, private, independent ballot.
And that's exactly what these voters asked for, equal access. They filed suit, and this past September, a Baltimore federal judge ordered the State Board of Elections to develop an online ballot marking tool in time for this year's general election.
Denying us access to this accessible online ballot marking tool was discrimination.
But Riccobono says there's still work to be done when it comes to the actual polling places.
Sometimes there's really not a dignity that we're presented with in the same way that the other people at the polls are. And that comes from a lack of awareness about the capacity of blind people and our ability to be independent.
Only two other states have adopted online tools specifically to help disabled voters. Riccobono says the change here in Maryland is a big step in the right direction.
Never before have we had access to absentee voting in this private and independent way.
In Baltimore, Allie Kessel, CNS-TV.